This is about how to make a mentee want to engage in a mentoring relationship. You'll be amazed when people try to start a mentoring program. The general thinking is that, oh my God, it is not easy to make this work. Why? Because how do we get enough mentors to come and help engage in a mentoring relationship? And lo and behold, they do everything to get a lot of mentors engaged in the relation, engaged in the program. Now they're thinking, next part should be very easy because we'll just announce it and there'll be a queue of mentees who would want this mentoring from these awesome mentors who are available, and this program will be a blowout success. Little do they realize that the hardest part is to make a mentee want to enter in a mentoring relationship. You'll be amazed why this is happening, because everybody knows that even a mentor or anyone for that matter, they need help. And here they are offering a mentoring service, sometimes for free, and nobody is up for taking it. Why would it happen? Let me say something. There are, in general, when it comes to certain things like learning, what people say and what people do are very different. For example, if you ask someone, do you like to learn throughout your life? Are you a continuous learner? Do you want to be a continuous learner? Do you want to be a lifelong learner? You ask the question in any which form or variation, the answer will always be, yes, I would love to do that. And why do they say that? Because saying no will make them look like an idiot. Because who would say that, I don't know, whatever I want in life, I've already learned. There's nothing more to learn. It looked like really ridiculous, irresponsible response. So they will say something that will make you not ask any more questions, because do you want to be a lifelong learner? Yes, the case is closed. But really, it's not that. Do they take action to be a lifelong learner? That's the real question. They won't. The better question to ask them is, hey, in the last 90 days, what were one or two books that you read? You got impacted by them so much that you changed some habit or some approach or some worldview or some strategy or some tactics. You are doing A, you are now doing B, because one of the learnings that you got from one or two of the books made you change it. What did you do? Usually answer is none. In fact, you'll be amazed. A general statistic is that an average person reads one book in 5 years. That's the sad statistic there. So now let's come to mentoring. It's even worse than reading a book when it comes to publicly acknowledging that they need a mentoring program. Although everybody knows that everybody needs help, when it comes to actually making a statement and raising your hand and said, yep, I need help. Sometimes people think, if I say I need help, am I making myself look weak? Although in public, if you ask them, do you think you will look weak when you ask for a mentoring help? They'll say, no, I'm good. I don't have any such problem. But will they actually do it? No. Second, when it comes to specific help, they are always worried that how can somebody who does not know them for a long enough time, how can they add any meaningful help? How will they know what do I really need? How will they know what I already know? How will they know that whatever they say, I've already tried it and did not work? So how in the world can anybody give me specific help without knowing my specific context in full and full detail in color and panoramic way? So they worry, but they don't say that, because then again, they may look arrogant or uninformed. So inside the mind, there are demons going on in their dancing in their heads that will make them not take action. But outside, they're always saying, yeah, I'm ready for it. So what do you do? I can go on the reasons for not taking action on a mentoring help, but let's not go there. Let's look at the solution. The solution is in two parts. One is the narrative is that needs to change, to go and tell them something else, a better story that will make them feel that they are not going to be affected by public scrutiny or public judgment about what they are being asked to do. For example, if you go and tell them that, you know, many successful people have openly acknowledged that they are very interested in getting second opinions for whatever they are doing. For example, if you ask a successful person, what was your plan and what was your outcome that you are going after and what was the plan to get there? And if you ask them a further question, are you sure that whatever you are thinking, all the assumptions you have made are going to be 100% right? They'll usually say no. At that time, if I'd asked them, do you think it would help if a really intelligent and competent person gave you a second opinion on your plan and strategy and tactics to achieve your outcome? Would it help? They will say yes. And they immediately say, who can I talk to? Because in this case, they are being asked about second opinions. That means the other person is acknowledging that they have the first opinion already. They are not there sitting idle or fiddling their thumbs, not knowing what to do, but they already have an opinion and a sort of a viewpoint. They just want to check and validate with some other person. And at this point in time, they are very open to a conversation, which is actually, in a way, it's a mentoring conversation, but it's not labeled as such. So they feel not intimidated or their self-esteem is not hurt. So they're just thinking, you know, I'll just get a second opinion, which means they're not putting the other person on a pedestal. But when they do actually have that conversation, if they are meeting with a really competent mentor, their worldview about mentoring changes and they get a bunch of aha moments because some of the assumptions would be exposed and maybe they were not as tight as they thought. Some of their strategies may be not as strong as they thought. Some of their tactics may need to be fine-tuned. All of them in a matter of half an hour, 1 hour conversation. And they suddenly think, oh, this was not bad after all, because it was not intimidating and their self-esteem was intact. And they do now see that the other person, a competent mentor, need not have to know them for 15 years to give some really insightful ideas to make them change the trajectory of where they were going, ultimately making them a better person. So one of the other things is to use things like this. You know, Seth Godin always says, people like us do things like this. You can say that most of the time you have observed that people, competent people, especially smart people, they don't think they need mentoring, but when they start having a conversation, their worldview changes about mentoring and as well as the openness to engage in one on such a relationship, because they see that if they have a blind spot. For a mentor, it's just a spot, but for the mentee, it's a blind spot because they can't see what the mentor can see. Third thing is that their own problems look very complex to them because they go after second order, third order, fourth order derivatives as they find a simple solution and say, oh, this solution will not work because it has these six problems. They go to another solution and say, oh, but that one also does not work because this has two other problems. And they keep going in a sequence until it's like a spider web and they're not going anywhere. That kind of burden is not there for the mentor. So mentor looks at it very objectively. And then he's not going to overthink about second order, third order, fourth order derivatives. Their goal for a very good mentor is to offer them a path to the mentee, which is reasonably good to move the needle significantly in the direction that the mentee wants to take, achieved by the strengths of the mentee and the current resources they have, and operates within the boundaries and limits that are perceived to the mentee is perceived to have. So within the available constraints, using their strengths and resources they already have, the mentor can help the mentee move the needle in the direction in which the mentee always wanted to go. Hope this is helpful for you to just change the minds and hearts of potential mentees to help them realize the value of mentoring and actually take the first step towards engaging in a mentoring relationship.